This is Bob. Bob dreams of being a world-renowned soccer player. He wants to play in the biggest leagues and in the biggest games, but there's a major issue stopping him from attaining this goal, and that's his rare and severe case of hemophilia. He bleeds a lot from everywhere. His skin is very sensitive, and so he gets wounds often. He experiences pain and swelling in his joints, mostly in his knees, elbows, and ankles, and when he goes to the bathroom, there's more blood to lose. So let's get into exactly what causes these symptoms. This is a DNA molecule, and its genes are responsible for giving us our characteristics. Their genes are responsible for making proteins called clotting factors. The clotting factors are what help us clot blood and stop wounds from bleeding. Unfortunately for Bob, the gene for a certain type of clotting factor called factor 7 is not working properly, and that's why he experiences these symptoms. Now let's see the effect of this within the body. Here we have a blood vessel, and of course it has plasma and red blood cells inside. The blood is flowing normally, but let's say you get a wound. There's going to be a tear in the blood vessel, making it lose a lot of blood. Now what usually happens is the clotting factors will stop the blood, helping in the sealing of the tear. But for Bob, because they're not working properly and they're not as abundant, they'll not be able to stop the bleeding. But how do we fix all of this? The answer is recombinant DNA technology, which refers to a series of procedures used to join together DNA segments from different species, and you'll see what two DNA segments we combine later on. In treating Bob's case of hemophilia, we're going to use recombinant DNA technology to produce a bunch of clotting factors. And this is done by taking the factor 7 gene and having it replicate inside bacteria. We do this using a plasmid vector. A plasmid is a circular DNA molecule that exists outside the bacteria's main DNA. It can safely carry the clotting factor gene into the bacteria and have it replicate. The plasmid also contains genes that give the bacteria special advantages, and one of these advantages is antibiotic resistance. This plasmid in particular is a PBR322 plasmid and has a tetracycline-resistant gene and an ampicillin-resistant gene. So the first step for getting the factor 7 gene to replicate is to insert it into the plasmid. This is done using restriction enzymes. They cleave in the plasmid at locations called restriction sites, which contain specific DNA sequences recognized by the restriction enzymes. Each restriction enzyme recognizes a specific sequence, and so when it comes across it, it will cut it from the plasmid. In this case, we're using a restriction enzyme, ECOR1. Now that the ECOR1 restriction enzyme has cut at its restriction site, we can insert the factor 7 gene in the plasmid. This is now a recombinant DNA molecule, since we have combined DNA segments from two sources, the plasmid from the bacteria and the clotting factor gene. The second step is to get the plasmid into the bacteria, which is done by bathing the plasmids in the bacteria in a calcium chloride solution, which makes it easier for the bacteria to take up the plasmids. Let's take a closer look at what exactly happens in the solution. As you can see, the bacteria and the plasmids are submerged, and our goal is to get the plasmids into the bacteria. Most of the bacteria actually won't take up the plasmids. It might be that only one or two take up the plasmids, so that's why we put in many copies. And even worse, we can't actually see which bacteria took up the plasmids and which didn't. In order to separate the ones that did take up the plasmid and the ones that didn't, we have to culture them in antibiotics. Why? Well, remember, the plasmid can give special advantages, such as antibiotic resistance. The plasmid we use had resistance to the antibiotic ampicillin. Only the bacteria that took up the plasmid containing the ampicillin resistant gene would survive. Slowly, each bacterium without the plasmid would die. Once we have the bacterium with the plasmid, we can replicate it, and those bacteria can make the clotting factors, since they all have the factor 7 gene in their plasmid. After they make the clotting factors, we extract them and mix them with sterile water so they can be injected. Now, we can give the injection to Bob and he'll feel much better. Maybe, just maybe, he could chase his soccer dreams after all.